Hello, my name's Angelo. I'm with Freedom Mobile Living, and the purpose for my video today is have to deal with some disparity I have with Lyft. I don't drive Uber. I drive just Lyft. I don't really care for Uber that much. I really don't care for Lyft that much, but I do enjoy giving passengers a ride with Lyft. It's not my total income. It's a part of it, and really, I use it more to attract business rather than I do to create business or create income. I do make some income from it, not a lot. I have to really watch it because our gas prices have really soared. One thing about Lyft is I've been doing it for about 3 years, but right now they're paying, in my area where I'm driving, they're paying like 10 cents per minute for time. So in essence, if you had to sit for a total of an hour and you do over a period of X amount of rides, you're going to make $6 an hour for that, which isn't even minimum wage. The second thing that they pay is 76 cents per mile, which doesn't equate to a lot. They came out and they decided to do something for the drivers. So they said, hey, we're going to give you a whopping 55 cents. 55 cents doesn't equate to anything for every ride. It might be a few dollars if you take a series of rides within an hour, but if you had one particular ride, and one I'm really looking at right now is a hotel or an airport, from a hotel to an airport in Tampa. So it's about an hour drive and actually 59 minutes, and it's 47.68 miles. So after being everything be equated, they do pay you for the tolls, but they only give you $1.07 for the toll, and the toll is $1.50. So right now you're going to take that out of your pay on your fares because the toll is $1.50, and they're going to give you $1.70. I don't know how that offsets your toll charge, but somehow they get it in their minds that that's what it does. I don't really think they think about it or they really care. The other problem, this whole job, I went from Bradenton, Florida to take somebody from a hotel all the way to Tampa for the airport, and I got a whopping $44.23 for 59 minutes of my time. Someone would say, well, that's $44 an hour. Well, it's not. You figure the gas charges in order to get there, that's a whole 59 minute ride. The second of all is, once you're there, what do you do? So how do you offset that cost? So only way I know how to is to start driving for Lyft when I'm in Tampa. So after I drop them off at the airport, now if I get a tip, some people have given me $20-$30 tip, that does help and offsets it, but why should I have to do that when Lyft isn't paying what they should be paying? I know a lot of people complain about it, and you really can't do anything about it because it's their company, it's their ball game. So if you want to play their ball game and you want to use them, you're going to be subject to the lack of pay that they give you, the lack of money they give you based on your cost. The problem I have with the whole Lyft gamut is that once I get there, I have to find some other rides and or offset my cost. Otherwise, I would drive a whole hour back, 59 minute back, and then I would have 2 hours for the $44, which equates to 20 per hour, which should, for your time and maintenance, and it doesn't even account for the maintenance on the vehicle. It's really a losing proposition. Most drivers will drive and they won't realize until that over time, not because they're not intelligent, is because they don't realize it until over a period of time. And over a period of time, they realize, wait a minute, I'm spending so much money on gas, so much of my time, and yet I'm not making that much money. Because some drivers will boast that they make $1,000 in a week, but if you were $1,000 a week, how much of that is gas? 200, 300? It's more like 300, especially with the price of gas right now. So how do you feel that you can make money doing that? Well, you really can't. So that's why I don't do it 100% of my time. I open up the gamut for other things. Right now, I just picked up a gig, which is kind of decent. It's twice a day is where I have to pick up denture pieces that I've worked on in a lab, and drop them off to doctors, dentists, and then pick up some partial ones that need to be done and then deliver them back. So it takes a couple hours of my time in the morning. It takes a couple hours in the afternoon, but I'm making a lot more money doing that than I was driving for Lyft. I still drive for Lyft because it's a platform where I can attract business as well. I also have gotten customers that have decided to use me exclusively for all their travels. So some of them are a lot. Some people I take every day. Some I take once a week. But regardless, I'm making a lot more money doing that. My profitability is higher because I have the customers. I bring the customers to me and I don't have to pay somebody else like Lyft. Lyft isn't controlling that for me. So really, how can somebody make income off Lyft? They really can't. So if you're driving Lyft, if you want to drive it and be picky about how you drive it and manage it so you can try to make as much profitable as you want. Once I started doing airport rides, I stopped doing them because of the time involved, the money involved in it, and the amount of money, as much of pay I'm getting or the lack of pay I'm getting from Lyft. I'm just flat out not doing airport rides. Now, when you turn the Lyft app on and you go ahead and you get a ride, they don't like you to cancel it. You cancel it and it goes against you. They can deactivate you over a period of time if you cancel too many rides. So how do I prevent myself from getting hotel or airport rides? One way I do it is by driving a little bit later, because a lot of times your airport rides are earlier in the morning. If I don't go so early in the morning and do Lyft, then I'll catch local rides, and I'm not saying they're highly profitable because they're not, but they're more profitable than it would be if I would have drove to the airport. So I've limited the airport rides because there's not, the profitability isn't there, and I'm looking to try to side my income in other areas. So I'm doing it for the dental lab, and maybe I'll open that up even more to try to do more of those. I'm also doing a lot of independent rides for people, because they are just tired of the unreliability of Lyft and Uber. One of the most important things that riders like is low cost, right? We all don't want to spend a lot of money, but what they really like is the reliability. They want to know when they want a ride, they get one. With Lyft and Uber, it doesn't happen that way. There's a lot of complaints right now, and a lot of them are saying that they've requested 3 and 4 rides and they don't get picked up. Now, some of it is their problem because tipping. I noticed the smaller distance rides, they don't like to give tips, or lower income people don't like to give tips. So if you don't add tips to it, then it really cuts into your profitability of doing the job. I just would rather not do it. So I do have some digital marketing I'm done. I just picked up Sunday, I took a family to church and back, which I do every week for them, but I picked up a website design job as well. So I'm gonna use that website design job as being part of my remote portfolio. So I'll do some of that. I also had the digital marketing, and I'm gonna try to grow that side of the business more so than I am the driving. If I find riders that want me to give them a ride and the profit is there, or my charge to them is there in order to offset my maintenance and my gas cost, I'm more willing to do that. I have some people that like to go to Universal right now where I'm located at in Bradenton, Florida. They want to go to Universal, to Orlando. That's a couple hours away. Now I can get better money because I can base my money off what Lyft or Uber charges. And I just drop it down by $20 per ride. I make a lot more money doing that. And I'll give an example. If I go to Orlando, I'm going to get anywhere from 150 to 175 based on the time. Remember, there's a time element there. So if I'm sitting in traffic, I'm going to get more time per minute. And I charge 40 cents a minute in order to do that. So that way, if I'm sitting in traffic, I'm making over $30 an hour. So if you take a bunch of rides that you do, let's say you did 5 rides, in those 5 rides, that's gonna offset my cost. And that's really what I'm looking for. I never understood them giving a 55 cents fuel surcharge as far as Lyft and Uber. They follow suit. One does it, the next one follows. But for 55 cents, how can that, in God's green earth, ever offset gas charges or gas cost. It can't. I think sometimes they look at people of not being very intelligent, so sometimes they throw it out, and then the people will try to work with it, and they realize it doesn't work, instead of trying to figure out, which I'm a numbers guy. My background's accounting, so I'm a numbers guy. I'm going to put it to the tablet. I'm going to figure out what my profitability is. Now, if I don't make profitability, or if I don't make the type of money I want to make per hour, I'll eliminate that part of the business. I'll eliminate those rides, or I'll eliminate that part of the business. Now, right now, I'm really spending a lot of time to try to open up my remote work as far as doing the SEO, the digital, and the website design. And that way, I can pretty much, that could be probably my total package of my remote. I'm also having rides on the side, which I'm picking up drivers or riders that are willing to pay more money because I'm charging them directly without having to pay a Lyft or an Uber. The other thing is my deliveries. I really don't care for food delivery because there's not a lot of money in it. What I do like is I like specialty deliveries. I like something like dentures to pick them up and have them take them to a lab so they can be done and then deliver it back to the doctor. There's more money in that, there's more profitability, and there's a little bit more dignity to that as well. And so I go around, I'm dressed properly because I'm acting professional, representing a lab, and right now I'm doing it like 4 hours a day. So how much do I want to work a day? I have that, plus I have my remote work, and then now I have the YouTube channel, which all my money goes into it and supports it, and it's not a money generation platform. Maybe sometime in the future it will be, but my gist of doing it is more about enjoying what I do, enjoying doing it, enjoying teaching people, enjoying also, I have the homeless problem, or we have the homeless problem in our country, and that's a real big passion of mine to provide some type of assistance for that, or to offset what we have in our country. Since a lot of people don't really care about it, you know, and I always say, do lives really matter? Do they really? I mean, we went into the Black Lives Matter, White Lives Matter, Chinese Lives Matter, all nationalities matter, but in reality, we live in a world that lives do not matter. Our government never cares about us. Nobody else cares about it. We have to look out for ourselves. And if anybody gets in a desire states in our country, even though it's a rich country, we don't help them out. I don't know why we don't. Maybe because we're only focused on what we want, what's in it for us. We live in a selfish society. And I think that's really the gist of it, is that I think everybody's just concentrating what they're doing every day. They're not really worrying about the problems of the world. And so they're very narrow-minded when they look at it. So really, if you got anything out of this video, go ahead and click the thumbs up, and then go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and that way I can alert you on new videos that come out. In the comment section, at least comment something about, if you're a Lyft driver or Uber driver, go ahead and comment something about how are you doing with the prices of gas. How is things transposing for you since Lyft and Uber only pays us 40%? Oh, by the way, on that airport trip where I was paid out $44.23, the rider was paying $142. So Lyft is making almost $100 off that of what I make, only $44. So really, is that fair? Not really. It's not really fair. What cost does really Lyft have into it, as opposed to us drivers? Us drivers, we have the cost, we have the maintenance, we have everything else. So right now, I'm starting to open up the gamut a little bit because the reliability is important. So if I have a handful of riders that I take every week, I make sure I'm there on time. I make sure they get picked up. I make sure they go to their destination. And then I give them that sense that I am reliable. It's been kind of growing just by word of mouth, and which is kind of neat. I'm in the process of opening the app in Florida because I think it'll be a lot easier for the riders to use the Ride Local app. And it'll be a lot easier for me to schedule or accept the rides as they come through. And because Ride Local is so universal, we also have a delivery portion of it. So I'm gonna probably utilize that too. So with I'm thinking about opening it, and I'm wondering what the great time to be or when I should do that. And I'm thinking in terms of maybe opening it within the next 30 days. Now, when I do that, I'll also open the gamut for other drivers to have the opportunity to utilize the Ride Local app as well. It's designed for drivers to receive 100% fares. And that way, it's more profitable for them to drive. And then we don't have lack of drivers because they're not getting paid enough like they do with Uber and Lyft. I notice a lot of times I'll put the app on with Lyft and it feels like I'm the only driver on the road, which 9 times out of 10 is probably true, because a lot of riders indicate where they can't get a ride. There's not riders. And then sometimes I'll get a ride from Lyft and it'll be like 19 minutes away to pick them up. That kind of tells me you don't have enough drivers on the road. Maybe if you treated your drivers better, then you would attract more drivers and better quality drivers. And then you can have reliability, which you need to, in order to keep your customers happy. Anyhow, I don't want to get long-winded on this. If you have any comments, please comment below. Let me know what kind of situation you're going to. If you have any questions, feel free to either comment below on the questions and I'll answer you as soon as possible. Or you can also call me at 616-952-1209. And maybe, with everybody's heads together, maybe we can figure this thing out. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to talking to you again. All right, bye-bye.